Welcome back to my Let's Play for Dark Cloud. Now let's head back into the Wyzal Forest for yet more monster slaying and item finding. So I can't rebuild this area without getting all the pieces back first. Even if it is a pain in the butt. Well, it's always a bit of a pain how these areas are randomly generated, but I guess it also means Earthless here, exploring the same place twice. Jeez. Darn, I got cut off. That's pretty sloppy fighting, too. And I'm not carrying any bread, so I can't even heal myself. Not be a healing point on this map. A rock. Yay, I can like throw that at the enemy, I guess. That's gonna be really helpful. Oh no, unless it's like a bomb, I'm not gonna be too excited about throwing a weapon. No matter what it does. Guess we go this way since it's got. Oh, the healing spring's over there too. Jeez, I'm gonna have to go run to this healing spring. Man, I'm sucking tonight. Heck, now it's making me think of Pokemon Emerald. So it's doing a pretty bad job on that too. So I get my money back?
Yeah.
Man, I'm just embarrassing myself tonight. But yeah, in Pokemon Emerald, I almost lost against two trainers in a double battle because my flying team got paired up against a cast form and a Manectric, and I constantly forget that Gyarados' strength lies in physical attacks, so I'll fight electric types and go flamethrower. Which is stupid. Gosh darn, my fighting sucks tonight. Oh, I was facing my target. Guess I'm not really in the best of moods for this game tonight. Oh no, I was hoping to get around to Arctolad, part of the Spirit Knight for an episode 2, but that may or may not happen depending on how much time I have left after I get this and Jakekun 2 recorded. And I was thinking about hitting up a short little RPG Maker game as well. But I also have cleaning stuff I want to get done too. No! Seriously, I'm fighting this thing from up close. That was close. Ah, yeah, I get it. It's almost broken. Shh. Yeah, I dropped some money on a revive powder, just in case I need it. Oh yeah, need to switch characters, duh. I don't know, I sort of like the second game a bit better, because it gives all the characters long range and close range attack weapons. Even if a wrench does make for a rather odd choice in a melee weapon, I imagine it'd be effective. I mean, wrenches are pretty heavy, but... which... Die, witch. I must condemn all witches. Gonna be doing that tomorrow. No resting just because it's Thanksgiving. Heck, I definitely know that. I'm gonna be at work tomorrow for 7 hours. Oddly enough, I'll be off for my birthday, but that's just gonna be another day for me too. Now let's open this chest. What we got? Come on. I'm not sure what to do with that. Maybe that's why I need to get to the back areas, but I tend to avoid those because the monsters back there are tougher by several degrees usually. Why is everyone's laundry hiding out in here? Actually, now that I think about it, where was everyone else's laundry in the last town? What, were they just own the clothes on their back, that's it? Otherwise, they just have to go naked? Some things are best not to think about. Die. Stupid spear wielder. Wait, I'm guessing this is the area. Exit out, right? Yeah, which means the map has to be in this last area. Again. Oh. Come on, kitty girl. Let's fight. No mere witch is gonna take us out. Okay. Ooh, pocket money. Ooh, big chest. What's it got? That was lucky. Ah, no, there's still slingshot. That might prove useful. Maybe. Another witch? I missed. Rat. Whoa. I honestly don't know if I want to use that or not. I mean, my experiences with those has been a bit mixed as of late. I got one to give me more weapon health, and then the other ones just start taking it all back. Negating the entire point of having them. If it's a negative effect, I'd rather put it on her. I lost money. How much money did I lose? Over 100 gold coins? Curse you, game. Okay. Well, I could head back to the healing spring to recharge on water. I've got bottles of the stuff with me already anyway. So it don't matter. Oh, I was close enough. Okay, now what's Sean? I feel like stones a lot. I don't know why though. To the next floor. I'm not sure how many items around this, or maybe it's a boss area. Well, mid-boss, I should say, right? Oh man. Curse you, game. Didn't want to hear that. you get thirsty quicker. Well, hopefully this is a smaller floor then. Nope, it's gonna be a big one. Actually, a better question is, do I have enough weapon power to survive this? Darn it. I might have to use escape powder. Completely exhausted already. Get thirsty a lot faster. Oh man. Another hornet. Okay, let's keep moving then. Try and kill this thing from a distance. Just get out of my way. This game's really not that generous on the healing items and stuff, is it? A lot of variety there. Whatever. You don't have a heart. I Honestly, I don't know if I should laugh or feel annoyed. This game's trying to make commentary on me. Cup of coffee? I don't drink coffee. Come on, we're almost through here at least. Darn it. Some more way too fast. I guess there's nothing to do about it besides drink up more water. I really don't like this area. If you don't bring a ton of water into it, you'd be screwed. Is that the exit? No, it doesn't mark those. That has to be a chest. Okay. Let's see. What's this? This is the exit route. Yeah. And we're gonna have to switch characters again when we find next enemy because. You can't fight with so little health, effectively. And I don't want to use revive powder. It's too expensive to be wasting it. Jeez. These long hallways make the water go burn through way too quick. It ain't worth it. If I get poisoned, I'll have to use up my last antidote, and if it's an explosion trap, I'll get seriously damaged and might die. And if it's a curse trap, I'd be annoyed, so it's best just to ignore it for now. But, oh, there's a spring here. Sweet. At least we can get the main character back into the fight. I still hate this area though. Seriously, use up more water faster. Dick move, developers, dick move. Okay, switch. Just die, Hornet. Why is it always in the last area? Seriously. Every time I've encountered the map, it's always been in the last area. Why is everything in here such a pain in my butt? Let me guess, I lost like another 100 gold pieces at least. Yeah. Might as well not even touch those. Unless I'm using a save feature. Like, it can't even be a minor inconvenience. It's always really big inconveniences, because it's hard to get a lot of cash right now. I mean, I guess I could technically go back to the last dungeon. Try and get around it that way. I guess I'll have enough health now to go deal with the big chest, though. Let's go see what it is. It's probably another slingshot, though. We get for our troubles. Come on. A bone slingshot. I don't know, is that even any good? Sorry. First person view. Very helpful. Weapons. Base attack 8. A bit fragile. Helps 40. I'm not sure if I want to use that or not. I'd have to probably look up online to see if which of these weapons are any good in the long run anyway. Not that, huh? How about the berry then? Berries, huh? Let's leave the dungeon. I have to go stock up on powders and stuff if I want to continue anyway. This game's constantly making you have to leave dungeons to go get stuff that the game doesn't want to give you. I definitely don't want to touch any more of those random points. You lose more than you gain, apparently. Water wheel. Okay, that's obviously a bucket. Nothing of interest yet. There's still plenty of stuff to find. Oh, well, next time I suppose we'll go further into the forest, and hopefully by then I'll have found some time in the grind, because I've been putting my spare time into Atelier Iris 2 right now. I've managed to max out Felt's attack. But that being said, until next time then, see ya.